या आई थिंक ये गुड, वी कैन स्टार्ट विद थ्री टाइम्स मेरे बाबा की जय। सो वी विल स्टार्ट टुडेस थिंग। थैंक यू ऑल फॉर जॉइनिंग। थैंक यू गाडेकर अंकल, हैप्पी टू हैव यू बैक। सो वी विल स्टार्ट विद थ्री टाइम्स अवतार मेरे बाबा की जय। अवतार मेहर बाबा की जय। अवतार मेहर बाबा की जय। अवतार मेहर बाबा की जय। सो ओवर टू यू गाडेकर अंकल, थैंक यू फॉर कमिंग इन। सो वी आर हैप्पी टू हैव यू। सो नाउ फ्रॉम सो इट्स ओवर टू यू फ्रॉम दिस पॉइंट।
ओके, थैंक यू गणेश। I thank you for giving me this opportunity.
Thank you, Baba.
First and foremost, I thank our beloved Meher Baba, who has been so kind to give this opportunity so that I shall be able to share some of this my ideas and some of the experiences with you this evening. It has been a very wonderful experience for me, and I am particularly thankful to the lockdown. Because of the lockdown, we are able to have this virtual program. And now some people are saying that this program is much better than the regular program because they are able to come together and they are going to be able to sit in their own home comfortably and enjoy the program and enjoy the Baba's stories of Baba and enjoy the stories of the glory of Baba. So it is a blessing in disguise given by Baba. So I thank all of you for joining. And again, I thank Ganesh. Now today, last time, if you recall, we had seen some of the experiences of beloved Baba, my own experiences of beloved with beloved Meher Baba. So in the same thing, and particularly these experiences in Guru Prasad and the Vadiyapak Darshan and story of Gadge Maharaj. So these were covered last time. This time we shall continue some of the stories of Baba. And one important story that I can recall, I can share with you right in the beginning. And that story is some of the very old stories I recollect in my mind, and some of them have happened even before I was born or when I was a very small child. And beloved Baba has explained the attributes of the Sadguru, in which one of the attribute is infinite knowledge. So Sadguru has infinite knowledge, and with this infinite knowledge, he is able to look into the past, and he is able to look into the present of all those who come in his contact, his devotees and his disciples. So in the same strain, there is a story which goes back to 1945, and this story took place in this event took place in South India, in the place called Chennai. Earlier it was known as Madras, and it happened in 1945. And in that city of Madras, there was a devotee of Lord Krishna, and he was praying before Lord Krishna. And he was in his hut, and every day he would pray. And in the hut, he had kept a chair. And during this prayer, he would always pray to Lord Krishna to come and give darshan to him, and to sit in the chair which he had placed especially for Lord Krishna. So this went on for many years. And he had firm belief that if anybody sits on that particular chair, which he had placed before the idol of Krishna, then he would think, he would be convinced that the person was Lord Krishna himself. So this was his conviction. And in the year 1945, when Baba visited Chennai, and he was visiting different places and going to house visits, and Iraj was also there, and without any previous knowledge to anybody, Baba decided that he would visit a particular house, and he went to that hut, and in that hut that person was praying before Lord Krishna. And Baba went inside the hut and he sat in the same chair which he had kept reserved for Lord Krishna. And then the person started weeping and he fell at Baba's feet. And he said that my life is fulfilled. So this is one example of the infinite knowledge of the Sadguru. Another incident I would like to share with you is that it goes back to 1948. I'm sorry, it goes back to 1948 when Baba was traveling extensively in India and doing his must work. And he would travel along with his close disciples like Iraj and Pendu and Kakabaria. So in the journeys he was traveling through a particular part of India in the train, and the train had reached the railway station around 3 o'clock in the morning, 3 a.m. And Baba had to catch the connecting train to go to the next place from the same railway station. So he was waiting in the train for the arrival of another train on the next platform, adjacent platform. At 3 o'clock in the morning, and during those days, the Indian trains were not very well illuminated also. So there was practically a dim light. And in that dim light, Baba was sitting and Erich was also with Baba. And those compartments were very uncomfortable. They were just wooden, hard wooden benches were there. They were placed in the compartments. So Erich and Baba were sitting there. Then when the train reached the railway station, Baba asked Erich to go on the platform and fetch some fruits for him. So he has alighted from the compartment and he went on the platform and was searching for the fruit vendor's stall. Luckily, he found one. And what does he see? He sees that the owner of the fruit stall has come there and the stall is cleaned and he's ready to start his business. But before that, he is standing in front of the picture which is hung on the wall. And he was praying before that picture. Eras thought that this would be the picture of God which he was praying. And so he went near and looked carefully and he was surprised because on the wall, the picture which was hanging, that was the picture of Meher Baba. So the fruit vendor was praying to Meher Baba before he started his day. Erich went to the fruit vendor and purchased some oranges and brought them to Baba, or some fruits and brought them to Baba. So when Baba saw that Baba accepted the fruits. And he asked Erich that, oh, you have got extra fruits. You return the fruits which you have not, for which you have not paid. So Erich goes back and returns those fruits. And he says that, Baba, he is still praying to your photograph. And now that you are here, in the compartment and same railway station. So shall I call him and shall I tell him and call him that Meher Baba is here on the very platform and you come and have impression. Baba said, no, don't do that. Erich was surprised. Why did Baba prevent Erich to go and fetch his devotee? Baba said, looked at Erich and Baba asked, why are you so much confused? Erich said that, Baba, I don't understand why you are preventing him to come to you. Baba said, looked at Erich and said, Erich, look here, his time has not come yet. His time has not come yet to meet me physically. So in this life, he will have to be satisfied with praying in front of my photograph. So that is the one story which I wanted to share with you, which is an example of the infinite knowledge of God. There are several such incidents. And another one which I can recall, it happened in Pune, and it happened in Guru Prasad, and Baba was in Guru Prasad. In the year 1960, suddenly, when Baba was in the middle of the program, he looked around and he just remarked that, oh, there's a lot of water in this hall. I see water everywhere. I see water all around. And Baba's program was going on. This darshan program was going on. The singing of bhajans was going on. And Baba remarked like this. So people were surprised that it was dry everywhere. And how is it that Baba is remarking that he can see water everywhere? Subsequently, this incident was forgotten. And exactly 1 year after that, in the year 1961, on 16th of June, there is a dam about 10-15 kilometers from Pune called this Panchit Dam. And because of heavy rains, that Panchit Dam burst and the city of Pune was flooded. And this incident happened exactly after 1 year when Baba had uttered the words that water, water, I see water everywhere. So this is another instance of the infinite knowledge of Sadguru. And for us, it is Sadguru Meher Baba or Avatar. And essentially, it is the attribute of Sadguru. Like that, there are many stories. And it so happened that in the year 1926, while in Mehrabad, Baba was sitting amongst his disciples. And Baba was in a very jovial mood. And he was very happy and very pleased. You can imagine, 1926, Baba had just started his silence. And he was looking so beautiful. And his whole face was shining. And the eyes were bright and like diamonds. And he had long hair flowing up to the shoulder, and they were curly hair and very soft, just like silk. And Baba was sitting along with the mandali in Mehrabad. And then he said that he looked at all the people around him, and he said that I want to ask you one question. This devotee said, yes, Baba, please ask this question. And Baba asked that, though I am present everywhere and I know everything and I am all powerful, there is one thing which I cannot understand. So people are saying, what is it, Baba? Then Baba said that though I know everything, I know everything, but I do not know one thing. So people were surprised that, and Baba asked the question, what is that one thing that I do not know? I repeat again, Baba asked the Mandali members that though I know everything, but there is one thing that I do not know. What is that thing? Then the Mandali started scratching their heads and they said that, oh, Baba, there are so many answers given to this question. And I can request you to give answer to this question. If anybody wants to give answer, the question is, Baba said, though I am omniscient, though I am present everywhere, though I know everywhere, there is one thing that I do not know. And what is that? That was the question. So can anybody give a reply to this question? I am narrating the incidents which happened in Mehrabad. Very interesting incident. Shall I repeat? Shall I repeat the question? Okay. I repeat the question. Yes, I repeat the question which Baba asked. Though I know everything, that is, though I am omniscient, I do not know one thing. And what is that one thing? So, any guess?
There is such one answer from Prakash. He's saying is infinity.
This is a distinguished gathering. What is the reply? What did you say, Ganesh? Sorry?
So Nimesh has said nothing. And yeah. Prakashji's answer is his infinity. So we have two answers.
But he himself is infinity, no? He has created the infinity. So, isn't it, Nimesh?
Prakash, yeah. And Nimesh has said nothing. Nimesh says it's nothing.
Nothing. So nothing is also created by Baba. So Baba knows nothing.
So whoever wants to answer can unmute themselves and answer. Anybody who has an answer can unmute themselves and answer.
BTS.
Okay. But what about this? I don't know myself in you.
Oh, well. It's a good attempt, I must say. I compliment you, Jeff, but I am sorry to declare that you have flunked. It is not the correct one. Any other guess? May I repeat the question, Betty?
Sure.
The question is, though I am omniscient, that is, though I know everything, there is one thing that I do not know. Such a distinguished gathering.
Wow.
I don't know. I'm remembering one time when I think he was looking at a child and he said he didn't know if it was a boy or girl, but it was a child that he was looking at. Is that it? No, probably not.
Oh, I'm sorry, Betty. So, any other guess? Any brave soldier?
What about I don't know anything other than God?
I do not know anything other than God. Then what is the anything other? Other thing is also created by God. And Meher Baba is God. So he knows other things also. Right? Yes.
I don't know my shadow.
Your shadow? I do not know my shadow.
Shadow of everything.
Ignorance. No, shadow is... Who created the shadow?
Baba.
So scratch your brains.
Please repeat your question.
Jeff is very clever. He can come out with the answer.
No, I think I've run out of answers.
Okay. So any other guess? Any other volunteer who can?
Yeah, anybody can unmute themselves. So anybody who has an answer can, or wants to attempt anything can unmute themselves.
Yes. Can he just repeat the question? Because I missed part of the question.
Oh, yes. I shall repeat the question. The question is like this. Baba said, though I am omniscient, that means though I know everything, but there is one thing I do not know. And what is that thing?
Is it bliss?
Pardon me?
Is it bliss?
Poem?
Bliss. Happy. B-L-I-S-S. Bliss.
C-L-I-F-F? No.
Bliss. B no. Is boy. Bliss.
Bliff.
Bliss. Like joy.
B-L-I-F-F.
No, B-L-I-S-S, bliss.
B-L-I-S-S, bliss, bliss.
Bliss, yes.
Bliss is, he himself is bliss, and he himself is immersed in infinite bliss. So, I'm sorry.
Maya.
Maya, who created Maya? Who created Maya? And in our arti, what do we sing? Maya bhi to tumhari chhaya. So that is also not. Is it correct? It is not correct.
Yes. I think.
So what is that one thing that Baba himself, in spite of being omniscient, doesn't know?
So Jeff has his hand up. So.
Oh, no, that was from before.
Okay.
Oh, that was for one before. You can try another one.
Yes. Oh my goodness.
There are no minus points. So
how about the beyond God?
Because beyond God?
Unconscious in the beyond state.
Well, he is beyond state.
Yeah.
He's in the beyond state.
He's unconscious in the beyond before the whim comes and he starts to know himself, he doesn't know who he is.
What doesn't he know?
In the Aarti, he's a Parvardigar says he's all knowing. So how can that he be not knowing anything?
But these are the words of Baba. He said, I repeat, though I know everything, there is one thing which I do not know.
How about the whim, the Lahar?
How about?
Whim.
The whim.
Whim, yes, you knew.
The whim changes and the whim comes up spontaneously. Baba's whim.
Whim is, who created the whim?
Baba.
Yes, so he knew about the whim.
You have to
know about himself. Himself.
No
he, yeah. Baba doesn't
about
know about.
Nothing. How about nothing? About,
about himself.
About himself. Baba. He knew about himself. He knew about his divinity. He knew about his state of being God. Such a distinguished gathering.
How about the nothing?
Nothing includes, nothing also is there, nothing.
Breaking of his silence.
Breaking of silence. Baba had himself said that, I will tell you, I know when I am going to break my silence. So it is not that he was not knowing. So Vijay, I am very sorry.
Yes, so.
Sorry,
so this must be a joke.
Good try.
You're pulling our legs.
Oh no, it's just a simple question and I expect simple answer.
Can you give us a hint? So can you give us a hint? So.
What hint can I give? See, you are such a intelligent people. Ah, very intelligent people. Full of knowledge about Baba. Do you want me to repeat the question?
Sorry. Hello.
No, we would like the answer.
Hello.
Yeah, repeat the question, please.
Hello.
Yes.
Ajay.
Sorry, this is Ajay here.
Yes.
Hi. Could it be that he doesn't know ego?
Ego? Who created the ego?
But he doesn't have ego himself, right? So he doesn't ego.
No, but who was responsible for the creation of ego in the human mind?
Yeah.
That's... So it's got to be the big zero, nothing, because he doesn't know nothing. He knows everything. So the everything and the nothing.
Please say it again. Some people may not be able to understand what you are saying.
What I said is that it is the nothing, because if he is everything, that is not nothing. And he is the everything and the nothing, but the nothing is what he would not know.
No, you see, he knew nothing. Therefore, he said, nothing he knew very much.
The big zero. How about human hearts?
Human heart, he created himself, and he knew every beating of your heart, every pulse beat.
What is that? So that, give us a hint.
Hint? Hint. What shall I give a hint? Well. This is very simple, you see. You are just to scratch your head and then it will come to you. And you may be having the answer hidden. Anyway, so shall I share the answer which Baba gave?
Yes.
Baba said that there is one thing, in spite of my being omniscient, in spite of the fact that I know everything, there is one thing which I do not know, and that thing is, I do not know where I am not.
Oh, Baba. Good. Wow.
Wow. That's great.
You see the profound statement which Baba made when he said that, I do not know where I am not. So that is another assertion of his divinity. So that is how it was. And there such programs would be there. And then Baba would give some puzzles like this. If you are interested, I can give some more puzzle of Baba later on.
Please.
If you are not already tired.
No, nobody's tired. So you can give more puzzles.
So that is how it was. Later on, subsequently, what happened that in the year 1953-54, the Una Bhajan Mandali was in full swing, and Madhusudan and party, they have become celebrities. They have become like rock stars. And everybody was talking about the singing of Una Bhajan Mandali. And Baba would call the Bhajan Mandali to Ahmednagar during the Sahvas programs and during these other visits also. So once it happened that the women Mandali complained to Baba that Baba, all this we have heard about the Bhajan Mandali and their beautiful singing, and the men Mandali always praise the singing of the Pune Bhajan Mandali, and you also seem to enjoy their singing. So, and you have heard them sing many times before you. But what is it that we are deprived? Why is it that we are deprived of this pleasure or of listening to their songs? And what sin we have committed that we are not able to listen to the singing of Pune Bhajan Mandali? Because you have given us order that we are not to step outside the limits of Mirzad, and you are not to see any male members, and you have given us the strict orders. But in the heart of our hearts, we feel we pray to you that somehow you see that we are able to listen to the music of Pune Bhajan Mandali and singing of Parisudan. Baba looked at the women Mandali and Baba said that, yes, you are having a good point. And yes, certainly your point is correct. So you should listen to the music of Pune Bhajan Mandali. So it is my order, you are true that you are not to cross the limits of Mirzad. But at the same time, you are very much keen to listen to the singing of Pune Bhajan Mandali and Marusudan. So what shall I do? We shall do one thing. I shall call the Pune Bhajan Mandali in Mirzad itself. So the women Mandali were very happy, and they were looking forward for the day when the Bhajan Mandali would come to Pune. So a letter was sent by Baba to my father. And in that letter, it was written that you, along with the Pune Bhajan, members of the Pune Bhajan Mandali, you and your family, you come to Mirzad to sing before Baba for entire day from 10 o'clock to 4 o'clock. And be punctual. And you come along with all the Bhajan Mandali. So when this letter was received, my father was very happy. And he read out this letter in the weekly meetings of the Pune group and the Pune Bhajan Mandali. And when this letter was read out in the meeting, all of them who had assembled, they were very happy. And they said that, yes, it's a great honor for us, and we shall certainly go to Mirzad and have Baba Darshan and sing before Baba. So it was like that. And they were so happy that they said that, yes, certainly. But Baba had asked the names of the persons who were to come. So he had written the letter to my father in which he had said that you send me the names. So he sent the names and Baba approved the names. And when the list was being sent, somebody was saying to my father that, Aho Gadekar Sahib, amcha pan naav ghala tyachyamadhye. पण तुम्ही तर गात नाही ना आपण आम्ही मागं बसतो मागं बसून कोरसमध्ये आम्ही गातो ना आम्ही पण गातो प्लीज इन्क्लूड माय नेम इन द लिस्ट बट यू आर नॉट अ सिंगर बट आय सिंग इन द कोरस नो आय सिंग इन बॅक आय सिट इन द बॅक अँड सिंग लाईक दॅट सो द लिस्ट वॉज प्रिपेअर्ड अँड बाबा अप्रूव्ड दॅट लिस्ट अँड द मंडली वॉज रेडी टू गो टू मिरजात. And for the, about a group of the list went up to about 35 or so. So it was decided that instead of going individually or instead of going by separate means, let us go together. And for this purpose, one entire bus was reserved. And this bus was reserved. At that time, this Maharashtra State Transport had just started. And all the buses were new, brand new buses. So one brand new bus was allotted to the Pune Bhajan Mandali's group. and we gathered early morning at Pune railway station to board the bus, and we entered the bus. The bus was smelling of paint, very fresh paint. So we were very happy that we have got a brand new bus to go to Pune, go to Mehrabad, go to Mehrazad for Baba Darshan and sing before him. So we occupied our seats, and all the Bhajan Mandali members had come. And then my father, then Madhusudan and Narendra and Pratap and Bahusaheb Deshpande, Madhusudan's brother, and Wahole was there, and Narendra Thade, and Krishna Bandelu, Narayan Bandelu. So many were there. Subhadra Bandelu, my sister Nalini, and we had gathered there. And we were ready to go to Baba and to sing before him. And so at the opportune time, the bus started, left Pune station, and we were traveling on the Nagar Road in the new bus. And while traveling, we said we should practice. So we were singing also while riding in the bus. But after about 20, 30 kilometers, the bus suddenly stopped on the way. And we were singing, we stopped to sing, and we inquired the driver, what has happened? Driver said that, don't worry, the bus seems to be something wrong, but don't worry, I'll go get down and fix it up. So he got down from the bus, from the driver's seat, and opened the bonnet and looked inside the bonnet, and he did something. And he just then closed the bonnet and then occupied the seat and started the starter. And the bus started. Oh, so we were so happy. So very loudly we said, Avatar Meher Baba Ki Jai. And the bus began to travel further down. And we continued our singing and practicing of the bhajans. And lo behold, after another 15, 20 kilometers, the bus again stopped. And when this bus stopped, the driver said, don't worry, I'll get down and see what is happening. So he opened the bonnet and again he checked up. And this went on for a long time, but he tried and tried, but he could not fix the bus. So he went on the other side of the road and flagged another bus and told the driver to bring the particular part of this bus which has failed. And we were waiting and we were looking at the watch, and Baba had given the time, 10:30. We had to be 10 o'clock. We had to be there 10 o'clock. And the watch was ticking here. And time was passing, and we were so much concerned and worried. Then with great difficulty, somebody, the mechanic came, and the bus started, and we again continued our journey. Now, in the here, what happens in Mehrazad, my father was already with Meher Baba, Ramchandra Gadekar. So what Baba said to him, that Gadekar, you go to the bus stand and receive the bus that is coming from Pune, which is the bus will carry the Pune Bhajan Mandali. So he went to Kusu quarters, that is Adike Irani's office, Dr. Baba's lifetime secretary, and he requested him he told him that I'm going to bus station to receive the Bhajan Mandali bus. And he said that, yes, I shall also come. Come on, get into the car. So both of them, in Adike Irani's car, which was a Chevrolet, came to the bus stand, and they were waiting. But because of this failure, there was no trace of any bus. And they were waiting and waiting and waiting there. Then Baba sent a message through Vishnu Master to Adike Irani and my father. And what was that message? The message said that please tell Adike Irani and Kadekar that there has been an accident to the bus and the bus has fallen in the ditch. The bus carrying the Bhajan Mandi had met with an accident, and in that accident, Digambar had died. That is what the message that was given to my father. And I do not know how my father must have taken that message. Probably he might have said that, Baba, you have given Digambar to me and you have taken him back to you. It's okay, as you desire, as you wish. So that was the message. And on here, this we were waiting. And eventually, somebody was sent to Pune workshop, motor workshop, ST workshop. And from that, the part was brought. And the part was fitted to our bus. And after fitting that part, the bus started. And when the bus started, again we said loudly, Avtar Meher Baba ki jai. And again we started singing. And at that time, the bus, thereafter, the bus did not have any breakdown. And it came straight to Erazad. And we were joined on the way by Adike Irani and my father at Ahmednagar bus stand. And my father wanted to come into the bus, but Adike Irani said that, no, don't board the bus. You continue my journey with me. And let's go and follow me, he told us. And we followed his car and we went there. And there, when we went, it was almost about 10:15 or so, 10:20. Baba had asked us to come at 10 o'clock sharp. And we were late by 15, 20 minutes. And when one by one, we got down from the bus and went to Baba. Baba was standing outside his cabin in Mirazar, outside the door. And he was flanked by Erich and Kakabaria and Pendu. And Baba was very angry. Baba said that who are these people? Then Erich told him, Baba, these Bhajan Mandi members, I don't want to see their face because they are late. Ask them to get out from here. Turn them out. Then it was such a shock to us. And, you know, we were just standing there. And some of us, particularly the lady members, they started weeping. And then Baba looked at them and said that, oh, stop all this, Ronadona. I don't want this. But then he said, eventually, in the end, he said that, all right, I forgive you. That was the sign. He will put his head, both the hands on his chest and do like this. That means I forgive you. Yes, but he said that, remember, do not do such a mistake again. So we just said, yes, Baba, we shall never do such a mistake. And then we went inside. And the instruments were there. And then Baba asked for the Sun to start singing. And the singing began. And that was around 10:30 or so. And it went on and on and on and on. And lunchtime, there was a break for about a half an hour or so, and thereafter it went. And around 4:30 or so, quarter to five, when it was beginning to get dark, the music over, Baba said that now it's all right. So we sang the Arati, and Baba was very pleased. Baba said that you have entertained me whole day, and I am so very pleased, I am very proud of you. And Baba embraced each one of them. Baba called Madhusudan first, then Subhadra, then all of us one by one, and embraced him and kissed us on the cheek. So that was the love of the Lord. And he asked us to board the bus. We boarded the bus. By that time, it was going to be about sunset or so. And you know that those days, there was no electricity in Mirazar. People, you would use lanterns. So somebody had brought the lantern and the sun was setting and the stars were beginning to shine in the sky. And we could see them through the leaves of the trees. And Baba came out of the cabin and he accompanied us to the bus. he asked us to get into the bus, and one by one all of us got into the bus. And then what Baba did, with his lantern in his hand, he went around the bus three times. Three times he encircled the bus with the lantern in the hand. And then he said that, now you can proceed. So we proceeded accordingly. And we just traveled straight through. And the bus, just like going like an arrow, which is shot from the bow. And we reached, we didn't know when we reached Pune. So that was one story of incidents which I wanted to share with you. Now, time for question.
Beautiful. Yeah, sure. Okay. Thank you for sharing that. Beautiful. So anybody, any question, can raise their hand or unmute themselves and ask a question.
I have no question, but I want to thank Gadekar ji for this wonderful talk. I got to go out at this time. Thank you, and Jai Baba.
Jai Baba, Jai Baba.
So we have one question from Betty.
Yes, please.
Dr. Gadekar, how many of the Pune Bhajan Mandali are still living?
Oh, maybe about a handful of them. Handful of them. About maybe, yes. Mm-hmm.
Thank
Some
you.
Some of them have gone to Baba.
Yeah.
Like Madhusudan and his brother and others. Ramchandra was another lead singer. But some of us are there.
Yes.
Like Pratap and myself and Narendra. And we try to keep the tradition going.
Wonderful. Thank you.
Let us thank Baba. Thank Baba.
Yes.
Yes. Any other questions?
Any other questions? I think people are overwhelmed with that question which you asked. So. So that's still like everybody is soaking in, so the answer. Anybody, any question? Jeff might have something. Jeff, you have anything to say? I think Jeff is there. It's quiet group now. So everybody is like kind of overwhelmed with that answer. Yeah. So there's no question, I guess. So here's one question that Nimesh has put on chat. I think Nimesh can ask, or I can just ask him. So Nimesh is like, his question is like, what was your father's reaction to the news that he heard when he was told that you had met an accident in the bus?
When he was told that, told by Baba that I know what has happened to the bus had met with an accident and it's a very serious, it has fallen in the ditch and it's a serious accident and many people are injured in that accident and Digambar has died on the spot. When this was told to my father, then my father looked at Baba and he said to Baba, that Baba, you have given me Digambar. And you have taken him back to you. It is as per your wish.
Wow. Wow, what answer. Profound. Yes, beautiful. That is a question from Mr. Ramakrishna. Yeah.
Yes, please.
Yeah. Mr. Ramakrishna, do you want to ask? You can unmute yourself and ask.
Jai Baba.
Gadekar ji, Jai Baba.
Jai Baba.
Jai Baba, sir. Breaking of silence, what is the position, sir, about Baba's breaking of silence and the secret book?
Breaking of silence?
Yeah. What about the breaking of silence and secret book, sir? Two issues, sir.
Secret book?
Yeah.
See, Baba has himself said that after Baba had dropped his body, people were very anxious to know about what is Baba's breaking of silence, meaning of breaking of silence. And they approached Hirach and other Mandali members. And why is it that Baba had not broken silence and all that? Then Hirach replied that Baba, breaking of Baba's silence has already started, and Baba is breaking the silence in the heart of each one of his lovers. So that is what Hirach said at that time. That breaking of silence is not the physical breaking of silence. That means as if Baba is opening his lips and telling something and tell some word or uttering some word. Breaking of silence, what did Hirach say? That Baba has already started breaking his silence in the heart of his lovers through their love to him. So that is the meaning of breaking of silence. And what was the second question? One was about the silence.
Wow, secret book, sir.
Secret book. He wants to know about that secret book which Baba had written.
Secret book, yes. The secret book, and you see, still it's a secret as far as my limited knowledge is there. So, there are many views about that, but I do not know. Frankly speaking, I do not know. Only it is his wish when that book will be available. Some people say it is infinite intelligence. Some people say something else. So I thank beloved Baba, and I thank all of you, and I thank Ganesh for giving me this opportunity to share.
Thank you, Baba.
To all of you.
Will you bring another quiz question next time?
There are plenty.
Plenty.
Plenty. Yes, yes. So you sharpen your brains in the meantime.
We better do some reading.
You eat a lot of almonds. Almonds in the memory. Wonderful to have you all in Baba's
Thank
love.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you, guys.
Everybody can unmute themselves now. So, thank you, everybody.
Okay. Thank you.
So we'll say three times, Avatar Mer Baba Ki Jai. Thank you, Uncle. It was wonderful to have you here this evening. And we will close this session by saying three times, Avatar Mer Baba Ki Jai. Avatar Mer Baba Ki Jai. Avatar Mer Baba Ki Jai.
Avatar Mer Baba Ki Jai.
Avatar Mer Baba Ki Jai.
Thank you.